Another feature that we see in an aircraft is thrust vectoring. In some aircraft, we give thrust vectoring for reducing its takeoff distance and landing distance. In some aircraft, it is given to provide vertical takeoff and landing capability as the requirements may dictate. So, a recent example of provision of thrust vectoring was the F-35 Lightning II, which many people feel is the last manned fighter aircraft that the US DoD is going to fund. Let us have a look at how this particular aircraft behaves when it goes for thrust vectoring. So, notice there is a complex interplay of many surfaces. Let us watch it once again to get a good idea about how these surfaces operate in unison. So, this is how it works. There is a dedicated lift fan in the front portion of the aircraft, which is normally covered in the normal flight or in the forward flight. It is covered by these cowlings and these bottom cowlings, and there is also a duct which is going to create two jets of air coming out from the main engine, and the nozzle of the engine, the rear of the engine, is also swiveled down. So, you actually are going to provide four vertical forces, and with these four vertical forces, the aircraft is balanced and it is lifted up. Thanks for your attention. We will now move to the next section.